That I, we are doing the activities of chapter 7. Okay, let me just say that activities are only 3 and it is going to be very easy, so it's going to be a very short video. So what is the activity 7.1 is saying and asking from us? See, we have to put some sugar in our mouth, then it is saying block your nose, put it how you're going to block it with your thumb and with your index finger, sorry, and eat sugar again. Is there any taste in the difference? So, and the third thing is saying while eating the lunch, so how the sugar is tasting? Obviously sugar tastes sweet. Taste difference, and if it's there, then why it is there? So yes, there is a noticeable difference. Why? Because perception of taste is created by our sense organs, nose and tongue together jointly, for any eatable item, basically, for that matters. What is happening? What are those receptors? Gustatory receptors in tongue and olfactory receptors in nose. Tongue receptors taste, nose receptors smell. Both these work together, and that's how we are able to taste or enjoy our appetite, our meal, you know. And the third question of this activity is saying that while eating we have to block our nose. So obviously, you know, children, whenever you have cold, at that time you are unable to taste any food. Why? Because your olfactory receptors are not working. So blocking of nose hinders the functioning of olfactory receptors which are present in the nose, and due to which the salivary amylase, which is secreted by the salivary glands, that's how salivary means there is some saliva in the mouth. How you come to know? Your mouth is always wet. It is never dry, right? It is because of the saliva, and it is secreted by the salivary glands, which make our food juicy and tasty, may not remain the same because our nose is not working properly. Hence, there will be difference in the food while eating. Activity 7.2. So what it is saying? It is saying कि हमारे पास conical flask है और उसके neck को हम लोगों ने cover कर दिया है with a wire mesh. Now 2 or 3 freshly germinated beans हम लोगों ने ले लिया है wire mesh पे हम लोगों ने रख दिया है. These are freshly germinated beans. Now what is happening? After 2-3 days, you will notice some shoots bent towards the light and roots away from the light. Why is this happening? Now you can see turn the flask and shoot are away from the light and roots towards the light. Leave it undisturbed in for a condition for a few days, or the old parts of the shoots and roots change direction. Are there differences in the direction of the new growth? How can we conclude? So have the old parts of the shoot and root change direction? The old parts and new parts both will change the direction. Yes, the change in the direction of the old parts of the root and shoot can be seen, but it is lesser in comparison to the new shoots and roots of the plant. Are there differences in the direction of the new growth? So obviously over here only we have said that there is going to be a direction, and it's going to be more, right? So yes, new direction growth will be there, visibly noticed. Visibly means immense or very much in comparison to this one. And what is that? Shoot move towards the light, you know, move or bends towards the light. Root moves away from the light. So what is moving towards the light? That is called phototropism, hai na? And which is move away from the light? That is called geotropism. Now activity 7.3. So it is saying identify the endocrine glands mentioned in some of the table in 7.1. So endocrine glands are all these. These are all endocrine glands, children. Hypothalamus, pineal, pituitary, parathyroid, thymus, thyroid, pancreas, adrenal, testes, ovaries in female, testes in males, right? So you remember, whenever you are reading or studying about activity 7.3, you have to correlate it with the activity 7.4. Everything over here, if your teacher haven't made it to write it down, then do let me know in the comment section, because I have made my children to write it down, and I will post it on the channel. So this is the second video. Please do watch it. If you haven't watched any of the videos, there are 150 videos on this channel. You can watch any of them and help yourself. I've completed the first chapter, that is chemical and chemical reactions. Second chapter, acid, bases and salt. Third chapter, metals and non-metals. I've completed, I'm on a way of completing now the 12th chapter, that is electricity. And somewhere here and there I've posted about 6th chapter, that is life process. And share it with your 10th class students, children. This is me, Alice Raj, and I'm signing off.